Google has just launched an amazing AI code editor which is called as Firebase Studio. This is quite similar to Lovable because this is completely online in the cloud. We aren't going to download and install anything. So you must all know Firebase, which is basically provides Google's authentication as well as database and many other stuff. This is just an extension to that. So now let's see how we can access it. So for this, just Google Firebase Studio. You'll be getting some documentation and blog post about it. If you scroll down over here, we're having this idx.google.com. So this is actually the link. So in case if you're trying to access this directly, you can just search for this idx.google.com and this will give you this particular interface, and make sure that you are signing in with your Google account. So this is the interface that we will be getting, and by default it allows us to create template projects like a Flutter one, a Angular one, Next.js, Node. So these many template projects can be created, and I even saw in a video like we could literally run Android Studio and develop like that emulator inside this itself. So let's see what are the features that it got us. So I just want to create a React project. So what I will do is I will just click on this new workspace and go to React over here, select it, and we are also having so many options to choose from over here. AI, ML, databases, so many things are available, like the templates, you know. So I will just go with React, and here we are having two options. One is JavaScript and another one is TypeScript. I will go with JavaScript and I will just give it a name and click on create. So this particular Firebase Studio is built top on Project IDX. So many of you would be knowing Google, like before a few months, created this online code editor quite similar to Visual Studio Code, which is called as Project IDX. So in case if you are a IDX user, all your existing projects will be like coming over here. So this is the interface that we are getting, like the default React.js files. We have the package.json, the app.jsx, everything, just the standard stuff, and it's running this npm commands. Basically we used to run that npx create React app, right? So it has its own terminal inside it, and just look at the interface. It's quite similar to Visual Studio Code, not quite similar but exactly similar to Visual Studio Code, but in a browser form. We are having the extensions, and it has almost every other extension that we have in Visual Studio Code, like this, and the debugging stuff, the version control in case if you want to use Git, the search and replace, and of course the files. And here is the place where we can see the output. It's just inside the web console, and if you want to like expand it, you can just, you know, open it in a new tab. Like in case if you want the full view, you can just open it in a new tab. So that's really amazing. Like you don't need to have like Node.js and, you know, mess up your computer installing so many things. You can just go here, you know, and develop. And another great thing is you can literally deploy your project within a flash. Like as you can see here, host web apps with Firebase. So we can literally deploy the application into Firebase. That's really insane. Like you don't need to have things on your computer anymore, like code on your computer. You can literally do everything in Firebase Studio. All right, so now let's just go and like create something. So this is the place where we will be typing the prompt. I'm getting this Gemini thing over here. So yeah, let me just change the model. So these are the models that it's giving us. I'll just go with 2.0 flash. 2.5 pro experimental is the best model, but I'll just go with 2.0 flash. Click here, and it will ask us to put the Gemini API key. So for that we can click on get a Gemini API key. It will take us to Google AI Studio, and here we can select create API key, and you know, select our existing project and create API in existing project. Copy this, and in case if you want to delete it, you can delete this also, and go to Firebase, put it over here, and now you can close it. I'll go and select 2.0 flash. Yeah, and let's start with a simple one. Create me an amazing and stylish to-do list app, and I'm using Gemini 2.0 flash over here, and let's see what it can do. So this is basically how it asks. Like, so it's going to install Tailwind CSS. That's amazing. So it makes changes in package.json. If you want to review changes, you can just click here. So basically shows what are the new code that it's going to add, and if you are fine with those changes, just click on update file, and it will proceed with the next set of changes. So it wants to install these stuff, so run terminal command, and as you can see the commands are getting executed. This is the output that I'm getting. I asked it to create like stylish and amazing, but this is what it has given, but I won't complain. So this time let's go with 2.5 Pro experimental model. And the great thing about Gemini models for coding is that they give you very high context length, like million context length, so it can like, you know, get reference to a large data. That's really important when you are coding. Okay, so now let me just go and ask a quite complex application. So this is going to be my prompt for Gemini 2.0 Pro experimental. Can you create me a CSV file dashboard app? So basically I will be uploading a CSV file, and it must be able to like show my data in amazing colorful charts and graphs. So let's see what it can do for this. And it is also having a upload in case if you want to like replicate like any image or something, you can just, you know, do that. If I go to the output here, it says me to like add a file. I'll just go and choose a CSV file and open it. So this is basically the output that I get. I'm just getting some graphs and I know what even this is, but yeah, this looks quite good. I mean, apart from the fact that the style can be better, like the looks can be more appealing, but at the end of the day it really does the job for me. And in case if you like want to more enhance it more, you can just say it like add more, you know. So that's the video guys, just use it and let me know how you feel about it. Do check the playlist of my channel, there are a lot of videos in programming and AI tools. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.